Very good morning, children. Sai Ram. So today we are going to start a new chapter, which is very interesting. Okay, chapter number 7. The title of the chapter is fractions. Okay, fractions. So before learning what is fractions, first we will learn what is whole. Okay, so if you have an apple, okay, and you did not cut that, then it is a whole apple. It is complete thing, isn't it? It is a whole complete apple. Okay, it is a whole thing. If you want to share that apple with your friend, what you will do? You will cut that apple into 2 equal parts, isn't it? If you have an apple, only one apple, and if you want to share the apple with your friend, only one friend, then what will you do? You will cut that apple into 2 equal parts, isn't it? One for you and the another part for your friend, isn't it? So after cutting that apple, you have 2 equal parts, isn't it? That is called fraction of a whole thing. Okay, that 2 equal parts are fractions of the whole part. Am I clear, children? Suppose you are having an apple. Okay, it is a whole thing, isn't it? It is a complete thing. Suppose you want to share that apple with your friend. Then you will cut that apple into 2 equal parts, isn't it? One part is for you and another part is for your friend. So those equal parts are known as the fractions of that whole part. Okay, have you all understood? Yes. Now we'll read, then you'll be clear. Okay, whole. What is whole? When a number, group or things is complete, we call it whole. Okay, when a number, group or things is complete, we call it whole. A group of things or objects taken as one whole is called a collection. Suppose if you have 2 apples, then what you will do? It is a collection. It is a whole, it is a collection. Then if you want to share the apples with your friend, means then you will give one apple to your friend and you will have one apple, isn't it? So that each apple is called fraction of that collection. Okay, suppose if you are having 2 apples, that 2 apples is called a collection. Okay, 2 apples are called collection. And if you want to share that apple with your friend, then what you will do? You will give one apple to your friend and you will have one apple, isn't it? So each apple is called fraction of that collection. Okay, a group of things or objects taken as one whole is called a collection. Okay, then what is fraction? When we divide a whole thing or a collection of things into parts, each part is known as a fraction of the whole or collection. Okay, when we divide a whole thing or a collection of things into parts, each part is known as a fraction of the whole or collection. So for that I have given you two examples, isn't it? Fraction of a whole means if you are having one apple is a whole thing, and if you want to share that apple with your friend means you will cut that apple into two equal parts, isn't it? So each part is called the fraction of the whole apple. Okay, collection means if you are having two apples, okay, if you are having two apples, that is a one collection. Okay, if you are having two apples means that is one collection, and if you want to share that apple with your friend, then you will give one apple to your friend, isn't it? So you are dividing the collection into two equal parts, one for you and another apple for your friend, isn't it? So that each part is called fraction of a collection. Okay, fraction of a collection. Is it clear? Yes. Then how do we write that fraction? So we write fractions in numbers as number of parts selected divided by total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay, number of parts selected divided by total number of equal parts of the whole. Suppose if you're having an apple, consider this is an apple, okay, and if you want to share that apple into two equal parts, then you will cut that apple into two equal parts, isn't it? This one for you and one for your friend. So we can write this fraction in numbers. Yes, shall we try? Yes. How do we write? Using this representation. Okay, number of parts selected. So for you, how many parts will come? Only one part, isn't it? Because this is for you. So total number of equal parts of the whole, and this is the dividing line. So first we will write the divided line, okay, and in the below the dividing line, what will be there? Total number of equal parts of the whole. So what is the total number of parts here? 2, isn't it? Because you cut that apple into two equal parts, so total number of parts is 2. Then how many parts you will have out of this 2 parts? Only one part, isn't it? Because this is for your friend and this is for you. Okay, so how many parts you will have out of these 2 parts? 1, 2, isn't it? 2 parts. So how many parts you will have? Only one part, that is number of parts selected. How many parts selected for you? Only one part, isn't it? So we have to write 1 about this dividing line. Is it clear? So we have represented in the fraction in numbers. We have represented this fraction in numbers. 1 divided by 2. Okay, 1 divided by 2. And how do we say this fraction? How to say this fraction? We have to say this fraction by saying the numerator first, numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, this is the numerator. The number written above this dividing line is called numerator. See, consider this fraction 1/2. Okay, the number written above this dividing line is called numerator. Okay, numerator. The number written below the dividing line is called denominator. Denominator. Okay, the number written above this dividing line is called numerator. The number written below the dividing line is known as denominator. Okay, so in this fraction, 1 is the numerator, 2 is the denominator. Okay, now we will learn how to say this fraction 1/2. How to say this fraction? By saying the numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. What is the ordinal name for 2? Second, isn't it? Second, first, second, third, fourth, fifth. So these are the ordinal names of the numbers, isn't it? So consider this fraction 1/4. Then how to write this fraction in words? That 1/4. Okay, so first we will write the numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, ordinal name of the denominator. Suppose if you are having the numerator greater than 1, that means if you are having 2/5, the fraction 2/5, 2 is greater than 1, isn't it? 2 is greater than 1. Then how to write this fraction in words? That is 2/5. So we have to add yes to the ordinal name. That's it. Okay. So first we have to write the numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay. If the numerator is greater than 1, then we have to add yes to the ordinal name of the denominator. Is it clear? Yes. Now we will read, then you will be cleared with the concept. Okay. For example, if a banana is divided into 7 equal parts, then each part is equal to 1/7. We read it as 1/7. How to read? 1/7. Okay. We name a fraction by first writing the numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay. Here the numerator is 1. So write 1. What is the ordinal name of 7? The denominator? 7th. Isn't it? So 1/7. Okay. 1/7. So if the numerator is greater than 1, then we have to add yes to the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay. For example, 6/8 is read as 6/8. Look at that, 8. They have added yes to the ordinal name of the denominator because the numerator is 6, which is greater than 1. Okay, so we have to add yes to the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, the next fraction is 2/9. Then how to read? two nines. First, writing the numerator and then write the ordinal name of the denominator. Here 2 is greater than 1, so they have added s to the ordinal name, nines. Okay, if 1 by 9, then it can be written as 1/9. Okay, 1/9. Is it clear? Yes. So next one, numerator and denominator. When a fraction is represented in numbers, the number written above the dividing line is called the numerator, and the number written below the dividing line is called the denominator. Okay, this is the dividing line. The number written above the dividing line is called numerator. Okay, the number written below this dividing line is called denominator. Okay, is called denominator. In other words, the numerator of a fraction tells the number of parts selected, and the denominator of a fraction tells the total number of equal parts into which the whole was divided. So we have learnt how to write the fraction, isn't it? Number of parts selected divided by total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay, so the number of parts selected is the numerator, and total number of equal parts of the whole is the denominator. Okay, see, for example, in the fraction 3/4, numerator is 3, denominator is 4. Okay, so the number above the line is numerator. Okay, numerator divided by denominator. Okay, divided by denominator. The number above this dividing line is called numerator. The number below the this dividing line is called denominator. Okay, children? So we will do the exercise problems. Okay? So see the first question. Write W for the whole and F for fraction in the boxes. So just we are going to write W or F. If the thing is whole, then we have to write W. If the thing is fraction, then we have to write F. Shall we do? Yes. So look at the first picture. What is it? It is a pizza, isn't it? Whether it is a whole pizza? No, isn't it? Because they have cut that pizza into small pieces, isn't it? So it is not whole, it is a fraction. So we have to write F in the box. Okay, F. Because it is not a whole pizza. They have cut the pizza, isn't it? So it is a fraction. So we have written F. Okay. See the next picture. So in the jar, there are so many cookies. Isn't it? Is it a whole thing or fraction? It is a whole, isn't it? It is whole thing. So we have to write, if it is whole, then we have to write W. So write W. Okay. See the next picture. See, what is it? It is an ice cream, isn't it? इट इज अ होल और फ्रैक्शन? इट इज ऑल्सो अ होल थिंग, इजंट इट? बिकॉज दे डिडंट कट दिस आइसक्रीम, सो इट इज अ होल थिंग. सो वी हैव टू राइट डब्ल्यू इन द बॉक्स. ओके, नाउ लुक एट द पिक्चर डी. What is it? It is a picture of apple and they have cut this apple into two equal parts. So, it is not a whole. It is a fraction. So, we have to write F in the box. Okay? F. Have you all understood, children? Is it easy? Yes. Now look at the picture of E. What is it? It is a cake. Whether it is whole or fraction, it is a whole cake, isn't it? Because they didn't cut the cake. So it is a whole cake. So we have to write W. Okay? W. Now look at the picture, the last picture. What is there? Chocolate, isn't it? Chocolate. Is it whole or fraction? It is a fraction, isn't it? Because they cut this chocolate. So it is a fraction. So we have to write F in the box. Okay? So you can copy down neatly in your textbook. Okay, children? Yes. So we'll move on to the next one. Represent the following fractions in numbers. Represent the following fractions in numbers. So they have given the fractions in words. We are going to write these fractions in numbers. Okay, so how do we say the fraction in words? By saying the numerator first, followed by the ordinal name of the denominator, isn't it? So the first words are numerator, isn't it? Numerator. And the second words are denominator. Isn't it? So easily we can find out. Okay, so these first words are numerator for each fractions. Okay, so for the first fraction, what is that? 1/3. 1/3. So 1 is the numerator, third is the ordinal name of the number 3, isn't it? So 3 is the denominator. Okay, so 1 is the numerator and 3 is the denominator. So this is the fraction in numbers. Okay, for the first one. Okay, so similarly, shall we write for the second one? Yes. What is the second fraction? 3/8. 3/8. So 3 is the numerator and 8 is the ordinal name of the number 8. So 8 is the denominator. Okay, so 3 divided by 8. Look at this, they have added yes. Why? Because the numerator is 3 greater than 1, isn't it? So they have added yes to the ordinal name of the denominator. Is it clear? Yes. So we will write for the third one. What is the fraction? 5/9. 5/9. So 5 is the numerator and 9 is the ordinal name of the number 9. 9 is the denominator. Okay, so shall we write? So 5 divided by 9. Okay, the last one, 7 elevenths. So 7 is the numerator, 11th is the ordinal name of the number 11. So 11 is the denominator. So 7 divided by 11. Okay. So these are the representation of this fractions in numbers. Have you all understood? Yes. So you can copy down in your textbook. Okay, children. So you can do your example problems in your textbook on your own. Okay, try that problems. Okay, children. So study well, stay safe. Thank you.